إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. من الله سبحانه وتعالى mentioned الصيام في سورة البقرة. The آيات, the famous آيات: يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. Then he mentioned أيام معدودات, and he mentioned the ruling of the traveler and the sick. In between these ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned a very important topic, which is الدُّعَاء. In between of these ayat, ayat الصيام, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. And when my servants ask you, O Muhammad, concerning me, indeed I am near. I respond to the invocation of the supplicant. When he calls upon me. So this is a sign that month of Ramadan, and specifically if you are fasting, this is a good time for dua. A very good time of dua. And we need the dua. I am fasting, I am praying, but also you need the dua. You need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You should live with the dua. You are praying, fasting, doing the Hajj, charity, all the good deeds, you still need the dua. Don't think that you are not needing the dua because already I am fasting. So for sure Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive my sins. No, you need the dua. You need always to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You need to show your weakness. You are weak. Even if you are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night, but still we are weak. We are doing the sins day and night. So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this ayah, the importance of dua. You need the dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. This is wajib. To invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and your Lord says, call upon me, I will respond to you. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Then he said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِرِينَ. Indeed, those who disdain my worship will enter hell, contemptible. Because you don't ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is a sign of your arrogance. You should show your humility to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your weakness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you read the Quran, you will find the greatest people, I mean the prophets, alayhim salatu wassalam, they were asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they are the best people. They need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Zakariya alayhi salatu wassalam saw Maryam ibnat Umran, كلما دخل عليها زكريا المحراب وجد عندها رزقه. Every time he enters the house, because he was taking care of Maryam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mission. وكفلها زكريا. So every time he was entering, he is the man who is responsible to get the food for Maryam. But every time he enters the house, he finds what? He finds the food with Maryam. Alayhim as-salam. This is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Immediately زكريا made the dua. هنالك دعا زكريا ربه. قال ربي هب لي من لدنك ذرية طيبة إنك سميع الدعاء. سبحانه وتعالى. At that زكريا called upon his Lord saying, my Lord, grant me from yourself a good offspring. Indeed you are the hearer of supplication. He hears the dua and he answers the dua, your request, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the dua in many ayat. أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَهُ. You are in a big trouble. Financial problem. Health issues. Marital problem. You should call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will remove any distress from you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَى. Is he not best who responds to the desperate one who, when he calls upon him and removes evil and makes you inheritors of the earth? Allah will give you more than what you ask him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-kareem, the most generous, not like people. You ask people something, they give you maybe half. You ask someone 100 KD, he gives you 50 KD, or he gives you nothing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-kareem, the most generous. You ask him something, he gives you more. This is very common in the Quran and the Sunnah. And in our life, how many times we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for something, he gives us more. Like the battle of Badr, which happened in Ramadan, 17th of Ramadan. The famous story, the famous battle, when they went to take this caravan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the victory. And they defeat the whole army of Quraysh. Subhanallah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned a very important hadith. You should think carefully about this hadith. مَنْ لَمْ يَسْأَلِ اللَّهِ يَغْضَبْ عَلَيْهِ. مَنْ لَمْ يَسْأَلِ اللَّهِ يَغْضَبْ عَلَيْهِ. Indeed, he who doesn't ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gets angry with him. Alhamdulillah, I'm doing my salah. I'm fasting Ramadan. I'm doing charity every day. Also, I'm doing umrah in Ramadan. In the last 10 days, i'tikaf in Masjid al-Haram. So what do I need? What should I ask Allah? Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the forgiveness. Ask Allah al-hidayah wa thabat, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His place in paradise already there, alayhi salatu wasalam. But the most dua he was saying, ya muqallib al qulub, thabbit qalbi ala dinik. Ya muqallib al qulub, the one who's turning the hearts, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today Muslim, tomorrow kafir. In the morning Muslim, at night kafir. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam mentioned, يصبح مؤمنا ويمسي كافرا. In the morning, مؤمن. Not in the evening. Afternoon, he is kafir. Subhanallah. So, the most dua. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was repeating this dua a lot. يا مقلب القلوب. Turning the hearts. ثبت قلبي على دين. Keep my heart firm on the صراط المستقيم as Muslim. Subhanallah. If you don't ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will be angry with you. And people are different. We are different. If you ask me one time, two times, three times, I'll be angry. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the opposite. You should show your weakness, because if you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this means we are weak, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the free of need, subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is a worship. الدعاء هو العبادة. As the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned, الدعاء, it is the عبادة. Because what is the meaning when we come for the Jum'ah and we pray? Why we are fasting Ramadan and we are doing the Hajj and the five prayers? We are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the forgiveness. So this is a dua, huwa al-ibadah. The main thing in the ibadah is the dua. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said during this ibadah, ad'u Allah wa antum muqinuna bil ijaba. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, supplicate Allah when you are assured of being answered. I am sure. Not I'm making dua and I'm thinking about something else, many things else. My tongue, my mouth with the verbs, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but my heart in a different world. Where is the answer? The answer will not come. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَعْلَمُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَسْتَجِيب دُعَاءً مِنْ قَلْبٍ غَافِلٍ لَهُ. And know that Allah doesn't, subhanahu wa ta'ala, doesn't answer a supplication which comes from a careless and inattentive heart. Heedless, careless. Not paying any attention with the salah and with the dua, with his Lord in the salah. اَدْعُوا رَبَّكُمْ تَضَرُّعًا وَخُفْيَةً. Don't ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with arrogance. I don't need, as if you are showing you don't need. Show him you need. This is very important. I'm repeating this because this is one of the main points of the dua. Subhanahu wa ta'ala said, call upon your Lord in humility and privately. Tadarru'an. Which means I need. I am a slave. I am a servant. But I am a king. I am a minister. I am a mudir. I am strong, I am rich. No, all of us are weak and poor. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuha an-nas, antum al-fuqara ila Allah, wallahu wal-ghaniyyu al-hamid. Oh people, everyone, antum al-fuqara, you are poor, you are needy. Antum fuqara ila Allah, you need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, huwa al-ghaniy, the free of need. الحميد, the praised one سبحانه وتعالى. قل ما تسمعون الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد. أما بعد, in the same surah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the next ayah, Surah Al-A'raf, وَلَا تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ بَعْدَ إِصْلَاحِهَا وَادْعُوهُ خَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا. So the previous ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, تَضَرُّعًا وَخُفْيَةً, humility and privately. And this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mention and invoke him in fear and hope. Which means your heart should be present while asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and really I need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be with me all the time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the prophets alayhim salatu wa salam. We need to repeat that, brothers, sisters, because we are repeating this when we read the Quran, especially in Ramadan. Wa ayyub إذ نادى ربه أني مسني الضر وأنت أرحم الراحمين فاستجبنا له فكشفنا ما به من ضر وآتيناه أهله ومثلهم معهم رحمة من عندنا وذكرى للعابدين. And mention Ayyub عليه الصلاة والسلام. He was sick 17 or 18 years. It is not only 1 month from one clinic to another hospital. 17 or 18 years عليه الصلاة والسلام was sick. Bedridden, alayhi salatu wasalam. They mentioned it was only his tongue moving, making dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he called to his Lord, indeed, adversity has touched me, and you are the most merciful of the merciful. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala immediately the next ayah he said, so we responded to him and removed what afflicted him of adversity. And we gave him back his family and the like thereof with them as mercy from us. As I mentioned, Allah will give you more. وَآتَيْنَهُ أَهْلَهُ وَمِثْلَهُمْ مَعَهُمْ. So we understand he lost his family. Allah gave him like his family and more. Double. سبحانه وتعالى. يونس عليه الصلاة والسلام ذو النون وَذَنُّونِ إِذْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا فَظَنَّ أَنْ لَنْ نَقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ فَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. Subhanallah. Immediately Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. ذُلُّون, Yunus, the Prophet Yunus, عليه الصلاة والسلام, when he left his country, he left his people, he stopped giving them da'wah because they disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala examined him when he was inside the stomach of the whale. في الظلمات, three darknesses, the darkness of the whale, the darkness of the sea, the darkness of the night. He asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. I'm one of the wrongdoers. Immediately Allah said, فاستجبنا له. We saved him. We answered his dua. The dua, brothers, sisters, this is the strongest weapon. It is ibadah. Zakaria, how many years? 70, 80, 90 years without child? وزكريا إذ نادى ربه ربي لا تذرني فردا وأنت خير الوارثين فاستجبنا له ووهبنا له يحيى وأصلحنا له زوجه. سبحان الله. This is the dua of the Prophet عليهم الصلاة والسلام, and mentioned زكريا when he called to his Lord, my Lord, don't leave me alone while you are the best of inheritors. So we responded to him again the same thing, the same concept. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا. Allah answered them because they have yaqeen, certainty. They are sure he will answer them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, what is the age? It is 70, 80. The wife barren, no children, maybe no ovary. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed that he will get a child. وَهَبْنَا لَهُ يَحْيَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him Yahya عليه الصلاة والسلام. So brothers, sisters, the dua in this month and all the months, the dua when you are closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين. آمنا في أوطاننا وأصلح أئمتنا وولاة أمورنا. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا وصدقاتنا وقراءتنا للقرآن. اللهم ارحم أمواتنا. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. اللهم نجي إخوان المسلمين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.